So today we're going to look at how you can add Google Maps into your business website and therefore boost your business, get more customers asking for directions and giving the right signals to Google so that Google starts to see that you're an authority because customers are interested in visiting your business or your premises. And later in the video, I'm going to show you some of the tricks and tips you can use to make sure that you get a good layout. So when you put your Google Maps integration into your contact page or into your listing or location area on your website, that you'll find that with the other little tips I give too, you'll find the layout starts to give even more authority and gives more signals to Google. I've also got a free scan tool that I'm going to mention a bit later on in the video for those that are there to the end of this video. And I'll give a link also to the description down below if you want to find out about that. And all these things, these scans, are going to make sure that your authority is very much in line with what Google's looking for. So all the tips on my channel are particularly aimed at trying to just help normal business people understand what it is that Google's looking for so you do things the right way and get rewards over time rather than quick wins that end up leading to being banned. Whether you've got WordPress, HTML, obviously just using HTML itself, or ASP pages, or whether it's more a case of you've got Shopify, or you've got Wix, whether you've got Squarespace, whatever it is that you're particularly using, there's normally an area where you can integrate HTML. And without using any API at all, Google Maps will just integrate nicely using an iframe. So this should work for your website, even if you don't use WordPress or standard HTML. You may be asking, why is it so important for me to put this map on my business contact page? Well, one of the main reasons is because it signals to Google that people are actually using Google products to find out more about your business. And Google rewards that. So if, for instance, someone goes to your website and they're looking to how to they can find you, so they then go to the Google Maps part that's on your contact page and they click directions, that sends signals to Google that someone is interested in your business. If 100 people do that, Google's going to reward you, going, well, this is an authority that local people are finding directions on. So it goes without saying, really, that anything that signals to Google that you're an authority, and Google Maps is one of those big ones that you can do, is going to have a positive effect on your business. If you don't have maps embedded on your business, it's unlikely that people are going to even know that they can get directions to your business. And anything that helps your customers, Google considers that as a good signal. So let me show you how it's really easy to do and add this onto your business.
So here's an example of the type of area that you may want to put your map on a landing page, and it obviously makes sense if you do that. So how do I get this and how do I get the right size? Well, there's two ways to do it. You can go to Google search and you can just type in your company name, which I'll do here. And then if you've got a map area here, as I've got here, you can click on that. And that will take you to your business within Google Maps. Now, of course, there's a second way to get here. If you go to Google Maps and if you just type in your business, and then that takes you to exactly the same place. So two ways to get there, both are producing the same results. Now, once you've then got this page here, and you notice that you get a real boost of traffic if you do embed your maps. And that's what you're after, really, is to get an increase in businesses and people finding your business. So what you do is click on share, and share then produces this basically an article or a link through to your website, which you can share this on Facebook or Twitter. But we're after embed a map, and embed a map comes in a few sizes. So you can click small and it'll produce that there. You can click medium. So basically you look at the web page, and if you wanted to fill the web page, then obviously you could go for large. And then all you do is whatever you decide, whichever size you want, you copy the HTML, and that's it. That is the iframe that then will be put into your HTML or into your Shopify site or Wix site or Squarespace, whatever it is that can take HTML. That's what you're after. Whatever takes HTML, you then copy that in, and it'll produce that without questioning for APIs. It gives it on a free account basis, which is really useful. And of course, you can also customize it. So say, for instance, you knew that the actual size was going to be, say 800 by 600. That's a good size, a custom size. You can preview that. So this is an 800 by 600. But you may then say, actually, I want it larger. I want it 1,000 but I also want it by 400. So now you've got this kind of letterbox style. Click that and it'll be similar to that. So you get the idea. You've got a total control over the size of this as well. And that's a really useful little tip. Just one other little tip, go back to here. You see that it picks an image for your business. And a lot of people always wonder, I wonder what that image is. What can I, if I click on it, nothing happens. Just a little tip here while I'm with you. If you click open it, the new image, you'll notice a very small image. But if you find where it says W and H, if you stick a couple of noughts or a nought even on there, let's just put a nought on those, and then refresh, you'll now see what the picture is. And if you really want to see the full picture, let me just go for another zero. What you're doing, you're increasing the height and the width capacity, and then you'll see this is the full image of that being shown. And that's kind of just useful to know as well if you haven't come across that before. So let's go back to this unusual size and let's just copy that. So copy HTML, and now I'll show you how I'm going to embed that in my web page. So this is my landing page, but this isn't actually my contact page. This is actually that powerful landing page with the video and the directions and so on, which I'm going to come on to show you how to do that a bit later. But on my contact page, I haven't got a map. And so what I might want to do is just, I might want to put it perhaps above here. So let's show you how I do that. So I copy the HTML here. I go to my web page and I now add custom HTML. So click on custom HTML. I then copy and paste that iframe in, and then I update it, and then I refresh it, and then you'll see, look, there's the map. And what's the advantage of this? Well, it just does combine the fact that my company name is appearing, the map's useful, people can get directions now to my company, they can add a review, they can see my reviews, they can get a larger map if they click on this. Everything about it is just helpful to my people that visit. But of course, as I mentioned before, there's also other things you can do as well. And I mentioned that on that landing page. If I just go to my landing page, you notice this again has got that information, but it's on a smaller basis. But a lot of other things here that I now just wanted to mention to you about how you get extra reviews and how you can increase the power of that map and those directions.
So hopefully you can see the benefits of adding this. It's really easy to do. It takes just a few moments. It can fit nicely into a page, whether it's small or large. You've got these different sizes. Remember, those signals are going to tell Google that you're finding, or you're getting customers finding your business. And that's going to be a very positive thing. But I also mentioned earlier in the video that there are other things you can do to enhance that authority and to give other signals along with Google Maps when it comes to your contact page, or maybe just a landing page that's specific to your location and your business. So what type of layout is it then you should be aiming for? What are some of the tips that you need to follow? Well, H1 tags and H2 tags on that page, particularly if you use the categories you're using in Google My Business, and also if you're using the locations that you want to aim at locally, those things need to be mentioned on that page. So your contact page needs to have NAP, which is your name, address, and phone number, and they need to be identical to the ones that you've used on Google My Business. On top of that, you also need to think about the categories, you need to think about citations, think about the areas which you've got perhaps social media, the links in, get those linked to. Adding a video is going to make the world of difference. Adding a contact form. Now, Google will notice all those things. Now, if you wanted to really make it easier, then if I explain all those things and show you how to do it in a video, you'd probably want to watch that video. And that's exactly what I've done. So head over to here now, and you can see a video on exactly how you can get the greatest, most powerful locational contact page. But if you want to know just more about Google My Business and SEO in general, then I'll see you on this video.